When a handful of university students in Sweden decided to make a game, they didn't really know what would come of it. But after Pinball Dreams turned into a surprise commercial success, they decided to turn their little startup into a legit business. And so, Digital Illusions Creative Entertainment started to make hardcore racing games while acquiring a studio in Canada. But their biggest opportunity came when they merged with Refraction Games, another Swedish developer with a World War II game in the works. In 2002, that game invaded the world as Battlefield 1942, a sleeper mega-hit that redefined multiplayer shooters. There was no question that Battlefield was about to become a flagship franchise for publisher Electronic Arts. And over the next few years, DICE would take Battlefield from the major conflicts of this century to the present and beyond. Immediately after 1942 was released, DICE went back to making racing games with 2003's Midtown Madness 3 and 2004's Rally Sport Challenge 2. However, everyone knew that another Battlefield game couldn't be far away. And indeed, in 2004, DICE acquired Trauma Studios, a group of modders who had made a popular mod for Battlefield 1942 called Desert Combat. Desert Combat took the 1942 engine and shot it to the modern day, recreating the Gulf War of the early 90s. It was a sign of things to come. But the next Battlefield game wouldn't be set in World War II or the modern day, and wouldn't even come from the Swedish developer. Rather, in 2004, Battlefield Vietnam would release from their earlier acquisition, DICE Canada. The Vietnam game was praised for improving on the first game's graphics, but was otherwise not as beloved as 1942. Despite crafting a 70s-era war game right down to the music choices, it just didn't take the franchise in any radical new direction. For the most part, people felt like it was a reskin version of 1942. While the game sold fine, it did not live up to the promise of its illustrious predecessor. Still, their publisher, Electronic Arts, had seen enough. In November of 2004, they publicly announced their intent to acquire DICE outright.
We've gained a lot of experience from each other throughout the years. For us, we were young and fresh, and we learned a lot. And at the same time, EA respected our honesty and learned a lot from how we made things. And then we've been going hand in hand.
It was a huge show of faith in the Swedish developer. And their faith was proven right with the release of Battlefield 2 in summer 2005. The fact that it was called Battlefield 2, despite being the third game in the franchise, said a lot about how Vietnam had been received. But this would be the first game in the franchise to be set in a fictional conflict, a two-front modern-day war between the United States, China, and the fictional Middle Eastern coalition.
There were talks early about making a modern warfare game, but we were slightly doubtful at times that we could execute within the amount of time we had and do justice to that setting with everything that comes with it, heat-seeking missiles, jets, everything. So for some time there, we were looking at Cold War era. We probably went through every little skirmish that's gone on planet Earth. But in the end, EA were quite constantly insisting on the modern warfare part.
In terms of gameplay, Battlefield 2 effectively dropped single player entirely, instead making it the same as multiplayer in the same maps, but with bots. But for the multiplayer itself, they added a number of team-oriented features. Each team now had a commander, a single player who could view the entire map and call in artillery strikes or vehicle drops wherever he wanted. BF2 also included a squad system, in which any one team could further split up into squads. Hardcore teams could now operate in small groups working in concert, just like an actual military unit. All in all, the change in setting, improved team mechanics, and unbeatable balance between real and fun proved irresistible. Once again, the Swedish crew had crafted a masterpiece, and reviews and sales went through the roof. Also, by switching from World War II to the modern day, it set the trend that other shooter franchises would follow in the years to come. Battlefield was leading the way. But all wasn't well in DICE's world. Only a week after Battlefield 2 went gold, and only 9 months after they'd acquired the little company, DICE shut down Trauma Studios for undisclosed reasons. The modding crew behind Desert Combat would go on to found Chaos Studios on their own. Later that year, DICE released Battlefield 2 Modern Combat, a console version of their hit PC game. Despite the same name and setting, it was otherwise a different game altogether. Even though the PC version was one of the biggest hits of the year, the console version just couldn't keep the same buzz. With 2006 came the biggest change for the company since their merger with Refraction. On October 2nd, EA completed their acquisition of DICE.
So the transition to becoming EA on the outside and forums, community and so on, there were a lot of fears that DICE wouldn't be what DICE always been. But I think we've proven by now that, and EA proven its intention with the acquiring of DICE, that DICE isn't bought to be, you know, to disappear into some gray mass. It's rather the new EA with separate studios that are kind of credited for their great work and are allowed to continue to do it. So I would say that we're quite happy with the current status, and we get a lot of credibility and freedom to do what we do best.
However, there was one problem. DICE Canada was a direct competitor with some of EA's own Canadian studios. Sadly, DICE was forced to close it down. Only 2 weeks after the acquisition finished, the Swedish studio completed their march through time with Battlefield 2142. As a science fiction title, 2142 went all out with mech warriors and futuristic guns. But as with Battlefield Vietnam, solid reviews and a fine all-around experience couldn't make gamers shake the feeling that it was a retread of a better, earlier game. While the setting was dramatically different, the actual gameplay was very similar to Battlefield 2. Like the 70s-era game, it sold fine, but wasn't a smash.
It's very easy to say, well, I don't like sci-fi. While, yes, it's a war game, it's a sci-fi war game. So we quickly noticed that a big part of the audience preferred the more historical or contemporary films.
But after their journey to the future, DICE would come back to the modern era to completely reinvent their franchise and surprise the gaming world with a title no one saw coming. Tune in next time to see how DICE broke away from Battlefield to do something completely off the edge.